databases are a little more limited than the web in that they contain only certain types of information resources, such as magazines, books, academic journals, and newspapers. Databases include less content, and therefore it's easier to find more reliable and relevant sources. For this presentation, we will be using the Academic Search Complete database, which you will learn about more in the database module. Most databases use the same basic search principles, so you can apply the technique shown here to many different databases. Remember our three goals. These still apply in database searching, and they are easier to control. Using specific keywords and the search techniques we have learned, we can retrieve a manageable list of relevant and reliable results. In databases, you still have to do more than one search and find more than one source. However, using the search techniques that we learned before, this is much easier in the databases. Because databases include less content than the internet, you will retrieve thousands of results instead of millions. When you begin to limit searches using specific keywords and search techniques, your results list will automatically be more manageable. Most databases arrange their results from newest to oldest, so you'll see the newest first instead of the most relevant. Most databases have save and email capabilities so that you can retrieve articles whenever you want. Our sample searches in this presentation are done using the Academic Search Complete database. You will be able to conduct the same types of searches in other databases as well. In Google, searching for the entire thesis statement produces some usable results. In a database, an entire thesis statement will produce few useful results. When a search retrieves no results, this database uses something called smart text searching, which tries to imitate Google and find results that are relevant by using some of the keywords you typed in. In databases, this is not very effective. As you can see, this search retrieved more than 70,000 articles, and it is not a good sign that the first two articles are completely irrelevant to the thesis. The first one is about cancer in animals, and the second one is about animals as carriers of disease. Databases usually provide more capability as far as narrowing searches and making the results list more manageable. In a database, a general search for animal testing results in 904 articles. You can reduce the results and improve their quality by creating a phrase search. This phrase search reduced our results to 316. I also want you to notice that the dates changed here even though we didn't change them. That's because the database automatically changes the date to the oldest source listed. If you want to manually change the dates, you can type a new date in the box or move the slider to the right. Databases also provide other ways of narrowing search results. You can see here that these results are already narrowed to only articles that are available in full text from the database. But you can also narrow by date or by whether a source is peer-reviewed. This database also gives you the capability of looking at only academic journals, magazines, newspapers, or book reviews, so you have more control over the types of articles you see. Limiting to just academic journals, for example, will reduce your results and give you a more specific list of results. Let's go back to this search. We got 316 results by only limiting to full text. That's not a huge number, but it may still be a bit too much to look through. Another way of limiting this search is by using our Boolean searching technique. So if we add the words "and cancer" to our original search, we get 12 results. This is a very manageable number. However, we have very few results now. People usually think, well, I didn't get a lot, so let me add a word to see if I get more. Let's see what happens when we add "and ethics" to this search. This means that you're asking the database to find articles that talk about all three things: animal testing, ethics, and cancer. When we added the word ethics, we got 0 results, and the database does a smart text search, which leads to articles that have nothing to do with our topic. As you may remember from the Boolean tutorial, this is because the operator AND narrows a search. So adding more words will produce fewer results. Remember which operator leads us to find more results? Remember in the searching techniques presentation how we created this complex search. We used OR, which expands the search and helps us to find more results. In this database, it's easy to perform our complicated search from the searching techniques presentation. A complex search that combines Boolean and phrase searching can be accomplished in one of two ways. You can either type this into the search box, or you can use advanced search. When you do this search in basic search mode, Boolean searching and full text searching are selected by default. When doing an advanced search, you have to select full text. It's not automatically chosen. Notice the difference between these search results. You should always do a full text search first because you can read the entire article right away. For most topics, you will find all the information you need in one database. Sometimes, however, if you need more articles, you can uncheck the full text box to see all the articles that are available for your search terms. Just because the full text article isn't available in this database doesn't mean you won't be able to find it. You may be able to get it from a different database, or the librarians can order it from another library. These quick steps should lead you to many good sources, but there are many ways of conducting research and many types of sources to find. If you sit down and do research and find everything you need fairly quickly, congratulations. If after an hour of searching you have found no sources that are reliable and fit for your topic, stop and ask a librarian. Librarians know many different research methods that take years of experience to learn. We know what to look for, and if nothing else works, we have access to sources that you don't know about. So, after an hour of searching by yourself, without success, ask a librarian. You will learn more about how to access databases through the LSCC library in the database module of this course.